The LibreOffice Draw module is often overlooked, but many of the Draw features are used in other modules like Calc and Writer. Those of you that have viewed the graphics topic or the font work topic in the LibreOffice Writer series have already seen some of the LibreOffice Draw features. Up at the top here we have our title bar with the name of the file that we're editing, LibreOffice Draw, our minimize, maximize, and close buttons. Below that we've got the menu bar, which has all our commands and features. And below that we have our toolbars. To know what toolbars we have, we can look at View, Toolbars. We see that we have the Drawing toolbar turned on, the Line and Filling toolbar turned on, and the Standard toolbar turned on. To know which one is which, if I put my arrow over the dots on the left corner of the toolbar, it becomes a four-sided arrow. If I right-click when I have that four-sided arrow, a menu pops up. And there, if I look at Customize Toolbar, it tells me I'm on the Standard toolbar. If I do the same thing on the next toolbar down, I see that this one is the Line and Filling toolbar. When I have the four-sided arrow on the dots, I can also move this toolbar by left-clicking and dragging. I can move it out in the open. Now we call this floating. To move this now, I would grab the top. I can anchor it to the right by putting my arrow over the corner. I can anchor it to the left, and I'll move it back to the top. Now it seemed to want to go onto one line to get it back into two. I just bring it down and drag it over. I got these in the wrong order. Let me fix that. In the Writer series, I changed this print button because the default value is to print the current document in its entirety to the default printer, and I didn't want that option. Since then, I've upgraded to a new version of LibreOffice, and I had to remove the old one, so my toolbar options were not saved in the upgrade. To get that option back, I'm going to add my own toolbar. To do that, I go to Tools, Customize, New, right here under the toolbar, New. We'll call this TFCG. I can save this for every draw. Every time I open Draw, it will show up on my toolbar. Or I can change this to only be available for this current document. I'm going to save this to come up every time I open a Draw document. I'm going to add the print button that lets me choose the printer and the number of pages I want to print. I'm going to add a Save As button, and I'll add the Bold button just to have a third one in there. Let's add those buttons. Originally, I don't know where these are. I would have to search every category looking for the commands. But since I've already looked through there, I know that in Documents, I'm going to find my print, not my print directly, but my print button that I wanted to add. And we see that it's added to my commands. And my Save As is also in here. And I wanted to add the bold because it's in a different category. It is actually in the format category. There's bold. And there's my new toolbar. If we look into View, Toolbars, we can see that TFCG is on. If I decide I want to delete that toolbar, I would go into Tools, Customize, select TFCG, and Delete. But I'm going to keep it on there for now. This big window here is our work area, And to the left, we have the Pages pane. To turn that on and off, we can hit that X, or we can use View, Page pane. Turns it right back on. We've got our drawing toolbar at the bottom and then our status bar. I want to place a shape from my draw toolbar into my work area. Notice that I have an arrow right now and the select is active. If I want to select a shape like this rectangle, if I click that, now we notice that our basic shapes is now highlighted. And clicking the arrow, we can see that the rectangle is in that basic shape. Because it's used so often, they've placed it on the toolbar as itself. To place this into the work area, I'll click on the rectangle, and we'll notice that we no longer have an arrow. We've got a little crosshair here. And we can see that the crosshair I'm setting at 1 and 1, and this will be my upper left-hand corner of my object. And I would drag by pressing my left mouse. And now I've got it 2, and we'll make it 2 on the top and 2 on the side on my ruler. We can see the edges of our object selected. If your ruler is not visible, you can turn it on by going to View, Ruler. Now I still have the crosshair, so I can create another square rectangle. And I still have the crosshairs to get rid of that. I can go down and click Select, or I can click Escape. And now I'm back in the Select mode.